हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। आई वेलकम यू इन दिस लेक्चर नंबर 14 ऑन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन प्रॉब्लम व्हिच वाज आस्क्ड इन जीटीयू एग्जाम। सो बिफोर गोइंग फॉर दैट प्रॉब्लम वी रिकॉल दिस फॉर्मूला फॉर क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। वी आर फैमिलियर विथ दिस फॉर्मूला ऑफ सॉल्विंग क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन इन रियल एनालिसिस, बट द सेम फॉर्मूला इज ऑल्सो ट्रू इन complex analysis also. So if you are interested in solving this quadratic equation in complex variable z, az square plus bz plus c equal to 0, where this coefficient of z square is non-zero and this a, b, c are complex numbers, so these coefficients can be complex also. So the solution of this quadratic equation has the same formula as we have the formula for quadratic equation in real variable. So solution is given by this formula: minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So here this b square minus 4ac can be a complex number also, so we will have two possible roots here, so that is the reason we have written only positive sign here. So here a, b, c are complex numbers, so we must have to find out square root of this complex number. And to find out square root of complex number, we have discussed shortcut formula in lecture number 13. So if you have not seen that lecture number 13, I suggest you to watch lecture number 13 first before watching this lecture. And this is the same formula as we are using in our school classes. Instead of variable x, our variable is complex variable z. So using this formula, we try to solve this equation. Here we are asked to find the roots of this equation. Same question can be asked in this way also. Solve the equation z square minus 5 plus I times z plus 8 plus I equal to 0. So we will use this formula, and before using this formula, it is better to find out what is b square minus 4ac and its square root. So first we compare given equation with that standard equation. Comparing given equation with az square plus bz plus c equal to 0. So if we compare, we can see coefficient of z square is a, which is 1. Coefficient of z is b, which is negative of 5 plus I, and term which is not containing z, that is constant, which is c equal to 8 plus I. So before using this formula, first we find out what is b square minus 4ac, and then we find square root of b square minus 4ac. So square of b means square of minus 1 into 5 plus I. Square of minus 1 is 1, so I write directly this is equal to square of 5 plus I minus 4. A is 1, c is equal to 8 plus I. Now here we can use that standard formula: a plus b square equal to a square plus 2ab, that is 2 into 5i, which is 10i, plus I square, and we multiply this bracket by 4, so 4 into 8 minus 32 minus 4i, and I square is minus 1, so we have this 25 minus 1, or we can write one more step: 25 I square is minus 1 minus 32, and 10i minus 4i, that is 6i. So this is going to be 25 minus 33, and that is nothing but minus 8. Okay, 25 plus 8 is 33, and minus 8 plus 6i. So this is value of b square minus 4ac, and we are interested in the square root of b square minus 4ac. So this is complex number, suppose we denote it by small w. Okay, we have used z is already used in this equation, so we are using another notation. Now to find out square root of this minus 8 plus 6i, we are using square root formula which we have discussed in earlier lecture. So for that we compare this with x plus iy. Suppose this is equal to x plus iy, then x is minus 8, y equal to 6, and y is positive, so therefore in the formula of square root sin y will be equal to 1. And what another thing is required is absolute value of this complex number which is denoted by w. So by the definition, absolute value of w equal to square root of x square plus y square. So square root of 64, square of minus 8 is 64, plus square of 36, square of 6 is 36. So this is 100, and if we consider positive square root, it is 10. So now we are able to use that formula. First we write down that formula. Square root of w will be equal to plus or minus square root of modulus of w plus x divided by 2 plus sine y into I times square root of w minus x divided by 2. So we have discussed this formula in lecture number 13. Now we substitute values of absolute value of w, value of x and sine y. Absolute value of w is 10, and what is x? X is minus 8 and sine y is 1. So here we have 10 minus 8 divided by 2, sine y is 1, and the square root of 10 minus minus 8, that is plus 8, divided by 2, okay, because x is minus 8, so minus x is plus 8. So therefore square root of w equal to plus or minus, now this is going to be 10 minus 8, that is 2, divided by 2, and that is 1, and square root of 1 is 1, so I directly write 1 here. This is going to be square root of 18 by 2, that is square root of 9, which is 3. So here I obtain plus 3i. Okay, so you can see these are very simple calculations. 2 by 2 is 1, 9 by 2 is 3. So these are the square root of b square minus 4ac equal to plus or minus 1 plus 3i. So we will use this in our formula for solution of quadratic equation. Now we write that formula. So in the next step we write that now z is nothing but minus b plus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So therefore z equal to, what are the values of a, b and c? So b is minus 5 plus I. So minus b will be 5 plus I. A is 1, c is 8 plus I. So we use these values here. B is minus of 5 plus I, that is 5 plus I, plus square root of b square minus 4ac is plus or minus 1 plus 3i. So that we write here plus or minus 1 plus 3i. Value of a is 1, so this is 2 into 1. So now we consider positive and negative sign, and we will obtain two values of z. So that I write here z equal to 5 plus I. First I consider positive sign, so I have 1 plus 3i divided by 2, and second root will be for negative sign, so negative of 1 plus 3i is minus 1 minus 3i divided by 2, and we simplify this. Here we have 5 plus 1, that is 6, plus i plus 3i, that is 4i, divided by 2. Here 5 minus 1, 4, I minus 3i, that is minus 2i divided by 2. So therefore z equal to, here we can cancel out 2, so we have 3 plus 2i, and here also we cancel out this 2, so we have 2 minus i. Here 2 will cancel out, so we have 3 plus 2i. So these are the roots of given equation. So sometimes they ask you to solve quadratic equation in complex variable. So it is easy to solve this type of equations. We just have to remember this formula, z equal to minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac over 2a, and for square root it is advisable to use this shortcut formula. Okay, here we don't have to find out argument of a complex number. Okay, so in this way we can solve quadratic equation in complex variable. So this is all about this session. I hope you like it. Thank you very much.